Here's a simple question with a deceptively complex answer. Where did Ozark millstones come from? Researching our recent video on the geologic backstory of Dillard Mill, we came across another tantalizing mystery. The current 1908 mill used roller mill technology to grind grain, but the previous mill, built in 1850, almost certainly used traditional millstones like this one. But where did these big, heavy items come from in an era when frontier transportation was very limited, and what were they made of? Stick with us as we investigate the mill rock mystery here on Ozark Outsider, because we found clues to a surprising possibility in the Dillard area. If you were going to grind grain, what would you rather use? A softer stone or a harder stone? Unfortunately, in this context, most of the Missouri Ozarks are underlain by relatively soft sedimentary rocks, like limestone. A harder rock like granite makes a far superior millstone, but such igneous rocks are only found at the surface in a small zone at the geologic heart of the Ozarks. So let's simplify this map. Missouri's diverse igneous rocks include volcanic deposits, like here at Johnson's Shut-In State Park, and pink granites, like here at Elephant Rocks. Early mills generally had to make do with what could be quarried nearby, so we shouldn't take all Ozark millstones for granite. The Dillard area lay well outside the Ozark igneous core, a long way to haul a super heavy granite millstone over rugged terrain in the frontier days when railroads hadn't arrived, roads were poor and non-existent, and recharging a vehicle meant giving your mule more hay. Intriguingly, there are some gorgeous granite millstones on display at Dillard Mill, but park staff told us these were donated to the park after its formation in the 1970s, so aren't likely to be original to the site. But this reminded us of something we'd noticed while researching the area. The presence of a mill rock creek just 4 miles from Dillard. So we started looking for more clues to millstone sources in the area. But at first glance, there was nothing to suggest why this particular valley was special. So we pulled up the regional geologic map, which does show a few isolated pockets of igneous rock well outside the main zone. And hey, look at that! This one way off on its own just happens to occur right along Mill Rock Creek. This little igneous pocket corresponds to an unusual topographic knob standing up from the surrounding landscape. Not surprising, since igneous rock tends to be much more erosion resistant than sedimentary rock. Aerial photography offered another clue. This leaf-off image shows a feature that sure could be an old quarry at the top of this knob. With a low-angle winter sun coming from the southeast, bright rock here implies a series of south-facing exposures, while the deep shadows here imply a north-facing wall. But this is on private land, so an on-site visit was off the table for now. But we had one more trick up our sleeve, well logs. These record the rocks brought up when a well is drilled, and are a fantastic resource for investigating Missouri bedrock. Sure enough, two wells near this knob record pink granite in their logs, suggesting a similar composition at the surface here. So we have an isolated igneous exposure, well outside of the hard rock heart of Missouri Ozarks, but within a few miles of the Dillard area, that probably consists of millstone-grade granite along the valley of Mill Rock Creek. That's pretty suggestive of a neat and tidy answer. There's even a road winding across the hills that makes a pretty direct connection between the possible quarry site and Hoosa Creek near the mill site. Does that road date back to the 1800s? But although scientists and historians love to wrap up data points in convenient narratives, we're hesitant to go too far here because there's a lot we don't know. What kind of millstone did the 1850 mill actually use? Were granite millstones actually quarried here? Were any of the millstones on display at Dillard actually used locally? So unlike a good mystery novel, we're going to have to leave this question unsolved. But the process of investigation was fascinating in itself, drawing on geology, maps, and history to read more deeply into this landscape. Oh, and thanks for unearthing our channel. Hopefully you'll dig deeper with some more videos.